show. Love-ins.
I love them all. I love them all. I'd probably adopt them.
Fallouts.
Just shut up.
She went mental about it, like it was a really massive issue.
And walk-offs.
She isn't nice all the time, is she? Got two sides.
Everyone hates everyone.
As four rival hosts compete to win £1,000.
I'd rather poke my eyes out with a blunt pencil than eat that again.
Home to the oldest inn in England, apparently. Been stood there, Longfella. Jolly good. And hoping to prove herself a golden oldie this week is our first host, grandmother and keen rambler, Joy Evans.
If I would try and describe myself, I would say...
Yes?
Crazy old woman.
Well, I wasn't expecting that.
I walk round the woods with my dog. And if I see an old man, I say, it's National Cuddle Day. Would you like a cuddle?
That's a bit weird.
Oh, and how are you today?
Yeah, you do know that's a tree and not an old man.
I'm hoping this week that they're a sympathetic, empathetic lot who like to help the aged and they'll just see me as super gran.
Well, let's see if they think your dessert is super. A Nottingham mess.
That's rubbish, isn't it? They just put the word Nottingham in Eat and Mess.
Not keen so far. Meet dispatch manager and collectible enthusiast, Coya Maddock Bradley.
I love collecting stuff. I like when someone says it's a one-off or, like, it's really rare, I want it.
There's a reason that Tico's is a one-off.
I couldn't care less what anyone thinks. I'd talk behind people's backs a lot. To the face, I'll just say, I say what they want me to hear. Everyone likes to be happy, don't they? And then by the back, I'll just be like, no. No, you're an idiot.
Well, that's delightful. Joy begins by whipping up a meringue. She whisks egg whites with caster sugar and a teaspoon of vanilla extract until fluffy. Someone's happy.
I like whipping meringue.
Good to know. Next up this week is dad of four and part-time DJ, Mark Feek.
That's it from me, Mark Feek, here on Aerowash Sound.
Due to my size, often people can feel a little bit intimidated by me. Obviously 6'5", 20 stone. I'm not someone who's going to be hiding away. I'm kind of in your face right from the start.
Hopefully, I might be cooking up a little bit of American pie.
I can be quite critical. Maybe don't do a criticism quite well enough myself. And apparently I do seem to think I'm always right.
Well, you seem rather pleased about it. Back in the kitchen, Joy's meringue is ready for the oven.
Happy!
Yay! And she's on to her main, plenty of fish pie.
Plenty of fish pie is just boring. I would go to the local pub for a fish pie, and I probably wouldn't order it then, so I'm certainly not going to enjoy it here.
Right! Last up this week, meet bank consultant Lachlan Forbes Sutherland.
I am definitely difficult to impress. I am a perfectionist, so everything has to be right. I like to do things perfectly, and I like everything around me to be perfect. I suppose in life, there are cooks and there are people who get served, and I'm someone who gets served.
Oh, you're terribly la-di-da, aren't you?
I've made the fish pie so many times, it's unbelievable, but I've never made this sauce.
And, of course, now's the perfect time to experiment.
This isn't in a recipe book. This was told to me by a dog walker.
And if you believe them, you believe anyone.
There's some chelon prawns and a couple of big boys as well.
She adds parsley and cream to her big boys and then blitzes it, shells and all.
Orgasmic.
Crikey, not the word I'd use.
Where have all the heads and tails gone? And the eyes?
You should know, you're the one in the kitchen.
Generally, the rule is just if it comes out the sea, you can lob it in there.
She certainly does that. Joy adds her rather thick sauce to a selection of mixed fish before topping with mash, and it's ready to bake. Finally, she cracks on with the starter. Stuff your mush, me duck, whatever that is.
If my guests have got a brain cell, they'll know what stuff and mush is.
Absolutely no idea what that could be.
I hope it's not soup.
It sounds a little bit Japanese, doesn't it? Mush me duck. So maybe it's, sushi?
Over to you, Joy.
Well, they're just stuffed mushrooms, but I thought stuff your mush sounded funny, and then I remembered that the Nottingham accent is midduck, so it's stuff your mush midduck.
Ta-da! Joy fries off chorizo, onions and peppers before loading into field mushrooms and topping with cheese ready to cook later.
This is stuff your mush midduck.
That is barking.
Hurry up, you haven't got mush time to get changed. Hey?
Dress code, putting on the Ritz. Putting on a bit of glitter. I'm not putting glitter on my face. I'm not doing that. I'm not an idiot.
No, you're a winker. There we go.
I like that. And that's my kind of dress code. That's brilliant.
Bring on the glitz.
I can hardly wait. First to arrive is, oh, very smart, perfectionist Lachlan.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, cute little dude.
Cute little dude.
Oh, you look lovely as well.
Oh, thank you very much.
Mwah. I'm Joy. You're black and white, the same as the dog.
You're a complete stranger. And she said, oh, I like your outfit. You match my dog. Lovely.
I'm not best pleased either.
Next up, it's Koya.
Hello.
Hello, beautiful girl.
Nice to meet you. I'm Lachlan. Give me a kiss.
Mwah. You're nice. I thought you were still going to be horrible.
That's good.
Do you know, wait a minute. There's one more to come.
Perhaps
more of averages. There's somebody horrible going to knock on the door. I'll set the dog on them.
Joy's nice. She's not wearing a bra, though.
Thanks for that. If you're last to arrive is Mark in a teeny tiny top hat and tails.
Oh my goodness! Oh, I say, I do like tall men.
Even if they've just dented your door.
Wow, well, you've outdone me.
The outfit didn't really suit. It looked a bit simple.
No one goes out like that. And your shirt doesn't fit me.
Cheers.
Cheers to a wonderful night and an even more wonderful week.
No, not the bagpipes.
Bagpipes? I'm not being funny. We're in your living room. Really? No, not okay.
She has a Scotsman come through. She never explained what he was doing there, and then he just walked off, and that was it. Crazy.
I can't believe how lovely they all are. I just love young people anyway, because it makes me feel younger. I love them all. I love them all. I'd probably adopt them.
Not sure how they'd feel about that. Coming up, party poopers.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, no.
She's on the toilet.
Can't believe it. I'd be mortified if that was my gran.
And cutting criticism.
I'm sorry to say, I don't get how you hold your pork.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's been driving me crazy.
You are a fussy little fart. Cheers.
Cheers
to a wonderful night.
It's night one in Nottingham, and kicking off the week is pensioner Joy Evans.
Cheers.
With Joy at work in the kitchen, her guests have gone for a snoop.
She always hang around with young lads, didn't she?
Look at him, she's feeling his bum.
Touchy-feely,
Joy. I can't believe it. I'd be mortified if that was my gran.
That is outrageous.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, no.
She's on the toilet. That's horrific. She's off a rocker.
Enough.
Back in the kitchen, Joy is giving her starter a unique finishing touch.
We'll do a J there and a Y there. And that's Joy!
Kind of. And there it is, stuff your mush, me duck. A stuffed mushroom with rocket and a creative balsamic dressing.
Oh, it says, oh, it's got your... Oh, Joy! Oh, fantastic!
Took me a moment.
Just out of curiosity, what's the rocket at the top for?
Well, it's just rocket's hand, and it was just a bit... looked like hair. I thought
you'd
like...
Oh, OK, so literal. OK.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Bon appetit. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you very much.
I think it's good. I like the chorizo, like the... of it.
I thought it must be mush me, like a sushi.
Mush me.
Like duck sushi.
Stuff your mush me duck. So me duck. It's a Nottingham.
Stuff you mush me duck.
Stuffed. It's stuffed. Oh. And it's a mush. Oh, you're slow sometimes, aren't you, darling? You do understand now, though, don't you?
I do.
It's a stuffed mushroom, so it's stuff your mush.
I do. Mm. I do.
Stuffed mushroom, yeah. Stuffed with everything from the fridge by the looks of it.
Ouch!
If I'm going to have any problems, I think it'll be Mark. I think he's a very, very, very strong character.
My initial thoughts about the starter was that duck would be involved somewhere and that the whole name was a play on the words. But unfortunately, there was no duck.
The starter was nice. I'm not going to lie to you. It was nice.
So what about you on the toilet then, Joy, with your knickers around your ankles?
I didn't do the album. My daughter did it for me.
How thoughtful.
Don't forget, I'm old. Senile.
Oh, so probably both at once.
You're not senile.
Sorry, what's your
You're
name
not
again?
Sick.
kudo.
I like Joy. She's like bubbly, and she's one of them people where you're just like, you're nice.
On with the main.
Ooh, it looks good.
Well, here it is. Plenty of fish pie with a bit of veg.
And I hope you enjoy it.
Get your pepper on now.
Yes. Go on, girl, get it all in there.
I love a fish pie. I have a microwave fish pie every day at work.
Every day?
And they're better than that.
Oh, dear. Your thoughts, please, Mark?
The darker bits, what are they? Because I couldn't work out.
On the top? They are.
No, no, underneath it.
Smoked haddock.
It's a topping parmesan.
Mmm. And breadcrumbs. I made the breadcrumbs myself.
Mmm, mm, that's good. I wouldn't
have. You made them yourself? Right. Stuck them in a blender.
How fantastic is that?
Do you expect it to be runnier, or do you expect it to be as it is?
I don't know.
I'm not trying to be horrible.
She had experimented with a new sauce, which for me didn't quite work. I felt it was a bit dry.
Mark said the pie was a little bit dry. I'll take that on board, and next time I make one, I'll do a little bit more sauce, because I like being saucy.
Well, at least the conversation isn't drying up.
I like to dress up.
I like to dress up.
I wouldn't go out, actually, out for a night out unless I'm in usually a three-piece, actually. And actually,
what
that's how
what sort of man goes out in a three-piece suit? Sort of man does that?
Does your three-piece give you a sense of power?
No, it's not. It's not power.
No, it's not.
No?
No. Looking good and feeling good.
Yes.
It's nothing to do with what that image projects to anyone else. It's how it makes you feel, and that's how it makes him feel. He likes going out in a three-piece.
Crikey, that's told you.
If there's an antagonist in the party, it would be Mark. I can handle Mark. I've handled bigger men than Mark.
OK, moving swiftly on.
I've enjoyed Joy, but Mark's not my cup of tea.
There's a bit left, but then I did serve extra large portions, so perhaps that's why. Perhaps they're leaving room for their pudding.
Yeah, that'll be it. Joy adds a final creamy squiggle and her Nottingham mess is living up to its name.
Shall we just all dive in, do you think? Get the spoons.
Jeepers.
And attack it.
Right.
Mm, the meringue's lovely.
Mmm. This is nice.
Don't speak with your mouth full, please.
That's good. I think it's because it's creamy.
We could play passing the stick round where I could go.
don't pass it to me. No, it's going to make me sick.
Taxi!
Don't like a communal dessert. I don't like it when she was like, share that with Lachlan.
I'd rather poke my eyes out with a blunt pencil than eat that again.
I think I'll get 3/8. And I think I stand a good chance.
I'm going to give Joy a 6.
I thought the night was really average. It wasn't ritzy, it wasn't glitzy. But Joy's great and I really love her, so that's why I'm giving her a 6.
I'm giving Joy a 6.
Ah, the joy of 6. So that's a total of 18 out of 30. It's day 2 in Nottingham and the turn of critical DJ Mark to step up to the plate.
I'm just the all-round guy. I bring a little bit of everything. I haven't got that one thing that I just do. I do everything well.
Oh, and so modest too!
Mark's quite opinionated, quite loud. There's not a lot going on behind the eyes.
I can see a few niggles coming with Mark. I think he's going to be the one to watch.
Yes, I'd keep an eye on him, as Mark has a sneaky plan.
Today we're all about saving time. Today it's not going to be a long, drawn-out affair where we're going to be taking all day to cook a few things. About having the dinner party at the end of it and not taking a day to do it.
Let's get cracking then. First up the main, beef in ale and Stilton with mustard mash and sweetened greens.
Oh, this sounds lovely.
It's quite an intelligent main, actually, and not at all what I would have expected from Mark, so he's really surprised me.
Oh, if only you knew!
I got myself some frozen mashed potatoes here today.
Mmm, frozen mash.
I'm just going to cook this up. Put a little bit of seasoning in it, put a little bit of mustard in it. And will anyone tell the difference?
Sneaky! While his mash pellets defrost, Mark browns off beef along with onions and mushrooms before adding a hefty glug of ale.
I just hope that the beef is tender and he cooks it for long enough, because I hate chewy beef.
Last to go in is crumbled Stilton, and it's left to slow cook until his guests arrive. Next, it's on to his starter, Auntie Lorna's pasta paralaccia.
Paralattica? Paralattica? Is that what I'm saying?
No.
It's focaccia, you pronounce. So paralaccia.
That's more like it.
This pasta dish we're doing today is from my Auntie Lorna. She used to prepare it for me, and one day I managed to convince her to give me the recipe, and I've been cooking it myself ever since.
Mark fried chicken with peppers, adding masala wine.
It's going to be beautiful.
That's followed by chopped tomatoes, and that's it for now. He'll finish it off later. Last up, dessert, maple pecan and walnut plat with custard.
Wow. Love pecan, love walnuts, love maple.
Mark begins by mixing chocolate spread with crushed nuts and maple syrup.
I'm using puff pastry. It's quite quick and easy to throw together.
Let's not put in too much effort, eh? With his nutty, chocolatey mix in place, he delicately plats the pastry.
It's not looking too bad, is it?
Not bad at all. Onto the custard.
It's that cosy hug, isn't it? Custard with anything gives is that sort of, it's a hug.
I wonder if he'll make his own custard.
Sort of.
Hey, so what we've got here is a lovely powdered custard, which is nice and easy to make.
But Mark's adding a couple of cheeky extras, vanilla essence and a vanilla pod.
I hope their eyes will say, this is an expensive custard. Their mouths will say, it's an expensive custard. But we'll know the truth.
It's a nice theory. With his corner-cutting courses prepped, he's off to get changed.
So, a little bit of trickery and deceit. Hopefully that's going to win me £1,000 this week.
First to arrive, and possibly not Mark's biggest fan, Joy.
Hi there,
Boy.
Joy.
Boy, how are you? I thought when I go, I will leave you a little joy.
How touching and slightly odd. I'm gonna get next up, Master of Manners, Lachlan.
Good evening,
Hello.
Sir. It's pretty three-piece, though, almost.
Yes, waistcoat and all.
Bottoms up, as they say.
And last but not least, it's Kaya.
Present from your granddad.
A
big plump for a big guy.
What? I know, you what?
Come on, everyone. Let's get ready for a great night tonight. Cheers.
Cheers.
While Mark cracks on with his starter, his guests go for a nosy.
Look. Pretty, isn't she?
She is, yeah.
He's done good. Cake. Is that a paper cake? It looks like it's made out of paper. I'm being funny, I would want more on my wedding day.
It looked like a nice cake. It actually reminded me of a nice castle.
In the kitchen, Mark's finishing off his starter. He adds olives and cream before turning his attention to the pasta.
It's really, really nice pasta. I couldn't make any better myself, so what's the point?
Yeah, it's only a cooking competition. Here it is, Auntie Lorna's pasta barilaccia. Good luck.
Paraloccia. It doesn't matter what it was, but it was bitter as hell. It was the stage before rancid.
What is it?
Chicken, peppers and olives in tomato, masala wine and cream.
Very, very unusual.
It's just slapping on a plate and getting it out there. You've just stirred up a bowl of sick.
Well, it's not stopping you filling your boots.
Who's Auntie Lorna?
She's your auntie.
My uncle was from Sicily.
That starter was Italian by that one olive he put in mine. That's how Italian it was.
So, Mark, we found some pictures of your wedding.
Your cake. Is it made out of paper?
The inside was polystyrene.
Oh, I see. So that actually wasn't cake at all?
No, it was there for photos and it looked nice and people would be wowed by it.
Oh, no.
Who has a non-real cake on the wedding day? If there's one day you can eat cake, it's your wedding day.
My wedding, if I ever get married, I want to get my hands in.
If I ever get married.
In my head. Double chocolate gatto.
When Koya said that she would shovel in her cake with her hands at a wedding, I was thinking, just like she does her food at the dinner table.
With the starter a bit of a flop.
I really enjoyed mine. Not everyone finished their bowl, though.
Mark moves on to his main, adding butter and mustard to his defrosted mash pellets.
Can't beat buttery mash.
Before sweetening his greens, really sweetening them.
A lot of these things that are good for you tend not to be very nice.
It would have been nice if you'd chopped your carrots. Here it is, beef in ale and Stilton, hidden under a puff pastry lid.
I can't believe it. I thought he'd been to Greg's and got a pasty.
It's lovely. I love the beef. It's so tender.
Did you make the pastry?
No.
Did you buy it and roll it out?
Why would you roll it out? It comes ready rolled.
Did you cut it on your own?
I did, yeah.
Make the shape?
I pre-scored it. And I deliberately went to the effort of cutting you a very small piece, so you'd be happy. Are you happy, Joy?
Yes, thank you, Mark.
Say it like you mean it, Joy.
Mark did his best, but he is a man. I couldn't taste the Stilton. I didn't like the greens. I didn't like the sweetness. I didn't like that combination.
And Lachlan's not happy either.
I'm sorry to say, I don't get how you hold your fork.
What, me?
Yeah, it's been driving me crazy.
What do I do?
You hold it like a shovel.
Do I?
Yes.
Oh, do I actually do that, though?
I couldn't care less what Lachlan thinks about how I eat. I'm like, I never want to be like you.
If I'm being picky, it really is that.
Oh, my...
Oh, my God!
I'm just saying. And it's
you
not...
are funny.
Well, very particular. Very
yeah.
Particular.
Yeah, I suppose.
You are a fussy little fart.
I think Joy's nailed down what she thinks about Lachlan. I like that. I like that, because he is a fussy little fart.
Joy's finishing off a lot of conversations, I notice, with... word and I probably wouldn't use, it's a little bit harsher than I would go in personally. I think it's coming out now, isn't it? That Joy isn't that lovely, sweet old lady that we all thought.
Maybe you can sweeten her up with your very little effort required dessert. Maple pecan and walnut platter served with sneaky custard.
Thank you so much for this.
This looks picture perfect. Very intricate, the lattice.
It's a lot of hard work.
Oh, yeah.
What am I supposed to do? This is how you eat.
Taxi!
Everyone thought, like, I was unetiquette or whatever they thought I was. But it's not my fault you overcooked the pastry. I couldn't believe it.
The only dish I really, really enjoyed tonight was the dessert.
Nice, hearty dessert. And it was. It was lovely.
If you'd have put more time into creating less gross food, you would have scored more than a 5.
I enjoyed the courses by the starter, so I give Mark a well-seasoned 7.
I'm going to give Mark a 6.
So Mark's shortcuts score him an average 18, leaving him level with Joy. Coming up, a hostile host.
Not really keen on any of them coming tonight, but if they have to, they have to.
And a potent pudding.
Oh, it's bitter!
What the hell's...
Dessert was abomination on a plate.
It's day 3 in Nottingham and the turn of dispatch manager Koya Maddock-Bradley to show us what she's got.
Having been to 2 dinner parties and there's been a serious lack of fun and everyone having a good time, I'm bringing that. Serve up anything. If they're having a good time, they don't even notice.
Not sure having a good time is top of everyone's agenda.
Last night, Joy was very, very direct. She was in people's faces, putting people down. So we'll see if Joy's got the same sting in her tail tonight or if she's going to mellow down and be that little bubbly old grandma she was the night before.
Are you going to mellow out tonight, Joy?
I don't think she's going to be any competition for me.
Well, you haven't seen what she's doing yet.
Tonight, I'm doing, like, a retro-y, kitschy, traditionally British do.
Makes perfect sense. She's starting with her dessert, Lemon Meringue Delight.
Well, let's hope it is a delight.
And?
And not a defeat.
How do I do this, then? I wouldn't be sick.
That's a good start. Koya mixes butter, flour, sugar and egg yolk for the pastry base.
Ridiculous. I can't believe people do this. I've never made pastry before.
You'd never guess.
I should have picked something easy. I should have done a cheesecake.
Ah, the beauty of hindsight.
Lemon's going to be lemon curd, so you just spread that on out of a jar, I'm guessing. She might have made lemon curd from scratch. I doubt it.
How wrong you are! For the filling, Koya mixes caster sugar, corn flour and lemon zest.
Do my nails in.
Followed by plenty of lemon juice.
We just guess, don't you?
Well, not really. She adds butter and eggs before heating till stodgy.
Smells a bit lemony.
Strange, that. She then smothers the mixture onto the base.
Ooh.
And tops the whole lot with... Oh, Koya, what is that?
I've never seen a meringue look like that.
Oh, a meringue! All righto. Next up, the starter. It's another British classic, prawn cocktail.
That is standard. That is just boring as it comes.
Whether it's dinner party food would depend on, I think, the style of prawn she uses. If she's just gone with the little tiny prawns, it's probably not going to be as nice if she's gone for some big ones.
Your luck's in! Koya begins by frying off tiger prawns and the packaging.
I think they're done. Never really cooked them from blue to pink before.
I wonder if she uses great big prawns or little prawns or decorates it with a giant prawn with its shell on.
How about a fat wedge of cucumber and lemon?
I think presentation's everything, because if it looks nice, then you're going to eat it, aren't you? Whatever it is.
Well, as long as you're happy with it. The prawn cocktails are left to chill and will be topped with sauce on the night. Last up, the main. Belly pork with spiced mashed potato and Yorkshire pudding.
I'm not eating a fatty piece of pork, like jellied eels on the plate.
I hope it hasn't got crackling on because of my teeth.
I've chosen belly pork because it's the best.
It's a definitely big fat man's menu, isn't it?
The meat goes in for a slow roast as Koya's dad drops by with a little appetizer to serve with her welcome drinks.
It's one of your dad's super special hedgehogs.
Oh, Dad, you really shouldn't have.
It's like classic British going down that sort of road. So this is it. This is British right here.
Doesn't it make you proud? After a quick change, she must be raring to go and keen to welcome her guests.
I'm not really keen on any of them coming tonight, but it's the after, the after.
What's happened to you bringing the fun?
Ayo!
First to arrive is Lachlan. Where's the three-piece?
I wanted to make an effort tonight.
That's brilliant!
Is this what your kind wear?
Her kind?
You like your ornaments, don't you?
What's wrong with them?
Nothing. It's just gives
a little bit of
them.
Personality, doesn't it?
Well, it gives it that.
My initial thoughts were, she's not even bothered to clean up.
Hello.
Next up, it's Joy.
It's Joy with bells on.
Oh, amazing.
Last in, Mark.
Hey, old ducky.
Right.
You're right.
It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
I bet you've never had one of them before. Oh, never again by the sound of it.
How's
that going for you?
I get behind you, Judith.
It's quite tart.
With the party well underway, Koya whips her starter into shape by adding shop-bought seafood sauce.
First course, nailed it.
They haven't eaten it yet. Prawn cocktail with a slab of cucumber and a dusting of paprika.
Put your hats on, then, and have a prawn cocktail. Get in, have it. There's bread there if you want it.
Did you make the bread yourself?
Did I make the bread myself? Look at this. Do you think I've made the bread? No.
So you didn't make the bread and you didn't catch the prawns?
Didn't catch the prawns. I cooked the prawns, though.
Did you cut the cucumber in these wedges? Was it supposed to be in wedges?
Yeah. Come on!
The sauce is really good.
Mm, it is good. The thing is, I was going to make the sauce and then I saw this one at 80p and I was like, not going to bother like getting all the components, but I can do this for 80p.
I did enjoy the prawns and I enjoyed the sauce, but what I couldn't get out of my head was the fact that she was so eager to tell us it was 80p.
I don't think she particularly is bothered whether we like it or not. She's never going to be a chef of the year. I've never seen such an eclectic mix of truly amazing, amazing teapots.
My dad, Joe, was an antiques dealer, so, like, he used to, like, drag us around antiques fairs and stuff like that. Like,
I think I'd like your dad. Is your mum still alive?
Yeah.
Joy was just so inappropriate with that comment about Koya's dad.
Joy has to have some word involved. Eat your food, put your teeth back in, and everyone will be happy.
Yes! I don't see any prawns in them dishes. Good, because I'd have finished them off, actually, to be honest. I enjoyed it. I thought that was all right for me.
On to the main, and she's making Yorkshire puddings to accompany her roast.
I've got a party hat on. I'm making some Yorkshire puddings for the first time, right.
Could life get any wilder? Just a shame your guests aren't feeling it. Joy! She's alive. Back in the kitchen and Koya's almost ready to serve.
I'm hacking it up and I'm slapping it on the plate.
After a hack and a slap, it's good to go. Belly pork with spiced mash and Yorkshire puds.
Cheers, darling.
Cheers.
When it came out, it was just slop on a plate.
I'm not sure what it was we were eating. It was just shredded porkness.
Did you boil potatoes?
Yeah, of course I did.
And did you peel them?
No, I didn't peel them.
You didn't peel them?
No, of course I didn't.
Boil ready pork potatoes?
Yeah, of course I did, yeah.
I didn't know there was such a thing.
Well, yeah, Maris Pipers.
You bought using Maris Pipers to make mash?
Yeah.
That's like one of the worst potatoes you can use for mash.
Is it?
The starch content of a Maris Piper is made for making more chips.
Is it really?
A Maris Piper is the best potato you can use for mash.
I would have said that.
All chefs will tell you to use a Maris Piper.
She went mental about it, like it was a really massive issue. It was just a throwaway comment.
It's like that, she was on the high horse. What? Maris Pipers? I've only grown them for that purpose.
Mark can be a bit vitriolic. I put him in his place.
Don't talk with your mouth full.
Well, I'll lose the impetus
so
at the moment.
Shut up. Just shut up. Hey, come on.
Joy's like really behaving really weird. What's up with her?
There is a lot of Mark Joy friction.
Sounds painful.
I think Mark particularly seems to be able to push her buttons, and she's being very easy to push tonight.
So, with the main and the atmosphere falling flat, Koya has a plan to win over her guests. Bingo, anyone?
We're playing for a line. There is a prize.
So you're going to want to win.
89. 27.
You should say 2 and 7. 27!
What, next one I will, Doc.
Right, Doc.
8 and 4. Knock at the door. Don't think that's there.
I wish. Nobody's knocked at my door for ages.
Number 7.
Get in. Ass.
Let me get your guys, Doc.
That is fantastic. A little teapot penguin.
Worth 30 quid.
It ruddy isn't.
For ages and ages tonight, I only needed one number, but Mark beat me to it.
I can't believe she's given me one of her teapots, just literally for getting a line of numbers.
You're a lucky, lucky man. Last up, it's dessert. Koya decorates her pie with icing sugar.
Winning dessert.
We'll see about that. And she's ready to serve lemon meringue delight.
I can't believe I've made it.
It's good. It is a palate cleanser.
Oh, it's bitter. What the hell was that?
Taxi!
Dessert was abomination on a plate.
It was just lemon meringue pie. How difficult is that?
I've had a lot of fun tonight. I've really enjoyed myself, but I feel the food let it down just slightly. I've eaten it all, but then again, I'd eat anything.
I think I'm in with a chance to win here. I really do think maybe I'm just up myself.
She was a good host, but everything else was a complete shambles, and for that reason, I'm giving Koya a 5.
I'm going to have to give Koya... Penwen, 7.
I'm going to give Koya a 5.
So a party pooping score of 17 leaves Koya bringing up the rear. It's the final day of the competition, and perfectionist Lachlan is hoping his ever-so-exclusive invite to dine will bag him the £1,000.
It would be very rare that I'd have these types of people in my house, to be honest. But I think the way to look at it is they've got in for free. They've not had to pay to come to what would be a once-in-a-lifetime experience for them.
Very decent of you, old chap. But can an evening of fine dining prevent an almighty ding-dong?
There's definite tension between Joy and Mark. It's going to go off.
Last night was fun. When we first got there, everyone was very bubbly, and I thought we were getting the old Joy back, but then as the night wore on, she slipped into demon Joy.
I do try and be upbeat and funny, but perhaps I do grind a bit on them.
Well, you certainly grind on Mark, but Lachlan's determined to rise above it all.
No one's going to ruin my night. I won't allow it. And it's going to be the best night so far, so there's no way that it can be undone.
Hopefully not tempting fate there. On with the prep, and he's starting with dessert. White and dark chocolate torte.
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 Boring. I'm not really a chocolatey puddingy kind of person.
It's easy. It's a doddle.
After knocking up a quick sponge, Lachlan melts dark chocolate with cream for a filling. He then tops it all off with white chocolate.
It has to look good, because you don't want to eat it unless it looks really good, so it has to be neat and tidy.
So not like that, then.
It should be rustic, but that I'm not happy with.
Oh, well, dessert done-ish. It's into the fridge to chill. Lachlan will attempt to rescue it later. Next, the main. Duck breast with a red wine reduction, don't you know?
Ideas of grandeur. These are all the most expensive ingredients I could find and throw on a plate, so let's try and make it work.
What a red wine reduction is. That's absolutely ridiculous.
Watch and learn. For his red wine reduction, Lachlan simmers down shallots with red wine and rosemary.
Lovely. Very aromatic.
Just a knob of butter to finish, and his reduction is ready. Simple. He'll cook his duck breast later on tonight. On to the starter. Scallops with peas, crispy pancetta and black pudding.
I hope pancetta's cream cheese. I think it is.
It isn't.
Well, we haven't had scallops this week, and I had adore scallops, so that, and I love black pudding.
The only thing Lachlan's prepping now are the peas.
I'm using frozen peas because it's not a dish that requires mushy peas, and if anyone expected them to be mushy, then that's just ridiculous.
Oh, I know. Lachlan will fry the scallops, black pudding and pancetta tonight, so after the peas get a thorough smashing, it's off to get changed. Meanwhile, his guests peruse the dress code.
Dress formal. Surprise, surprise.
So that'll be everyone getting their three-piece out and the old pocket watch, no doubt.
Well, here he is, the Lord of the Manor, ready to greet his first guest.
Good evening.
It's Mark.
How are you, Mark? Come in.
This is proper.
There we go.
Yeah, hey. Look at that, nice village.
Next up, a regal-looking Koya.
Look at you! Look at you!
Looking great, baby.
Last at the door, it's Joy.
Welcome.
Dolly.
Look at you.
Armed with a prezi for Koya.
Oh, that's brilliant.
And another for Lachlan.
Thank you.
I bought you a squeezy, Joy, so you can cuddle me.
Oh.
Wow.
And for Mark? Good. Nice lipstick, by the way, Mark.
Well, I haven't got one for you.
I'll tell you what, if I felt surprised, I'd let you know.
I'm not bothered about not getting a present in general. I'm just bothered about the fact that it kind of singles me out.
Oh, diddums.
I want them to have a good time, and I really don't think it helped that Joy came in with a gift for me, which was lovely, but also a gift for Koya and nothing for Mark.
Yay. Cheers.
Cheers.
Coming up, touchy talk.
If it's a dream, it's a perfect world. That's the whole point of a dream. A dream is a perfect world.
It's not my kind of person, and that's disgusting.
And someone wins a grand.
In joint third place...
It's the last night of the competition in Nottingham, and bank consultant Lachlan Forbes Sutherland is aiming to give everyone a taste of the fine life in a bid to win £1,000. As his guests settle at the table, Lachlan finishes off his starter. First, he fries off his scallops. Deep breaths, Lachlan.
There's one that's picked up a little bit of caramelisation on the bottom.
You mean it's burnt? He then moves on to the black pudding and pancetta before delicately dishing it up along with crushed peas.
It will go down a storm. I think everyone's going to be really impressed.
Scallops with peas, crispy pancetta and black pudding.
The peas, are they processed?
They're smashed just to get them a bit textured so you can fit them onto your...
They're normal, everyday peas, but...
They are, yeah. Oh, no, they're not processed. I've just smashed them with a fork.
Okay, that's why I'm asking. Don't take everything as a criticism.
Is
sometimes
normal?
It's just an inquisitive thing.
Oh, it's a bit awkward.
Are these mini scallops?
They are queen scallops.
They look lovely, but the size of them scallops, they were tiny.
It wasn't as classy as it said it was.
In my head, without knowing any better, they're just shriveled scallops.
Back at the table, Mark's not feeling the love.
I've got no joy in my life.
Oh, come on, Mark. You've got a little bit of joy.
Oh, in real joy? Or do you mean that joy?
Both joys.
Oh.
Both joys. Come on,
it's
eat
our last night. Let's all have a good time.
Yeah.
You know, I'm having a good time.
Are you sulking now?
I'm not sulking.
Oh, you're having a sulk on because I didn't bring you a present tonight.
That's quite the point. You were the one that bought presents for everyone else and not for me.
Darling, I brought you a joy to your house.
Then you bought more presents tonight, didn't you? I mean, you knew more about people.
Everyone hates everyone. I think I'm the only one that is, like, talking to all three of them. You want to try sitting in a room with them three?
Not really.
So I think that was a bit of a mixed bag, from the point of view of the starter.
You're telling me!
Koya seemed to really enjoy it. I don't really know Joy's opinion because she's still being quite difficult tonight and I'm really finding it hard to gauge where she's going to go next. I think Mark is trying to unsettle me as much as he can.
Rise above it, Lachlan, rise above it. For his main, he cooks off the duck breast, plates it up on a bed of mashed veg and finishes with his red wine reduction and a few pomegranate seeds. It's good to go. Oh, this is nice. Nothing to say, anyone? Anyone?
Was it an Indian runner duck?
I have no idea what that means.
There ain't no party in the dinner party. We've got a dinner, thank goodness, but there weren't no party there.
I was fully expectant that there would be no offer of how you wanted the duck breast cooked. It would just be, this is how people have it who are like me, and this is how you will have it, and you'll bloody well enjoy it.
The duck was quite rare. It wasn't to my liking.
Come on, Lachlan, let's see if you can lift the gloom.
What is everyone's outlook on life? What does everyone aspire to achieve in life?
That's the spirit!
I don't know. I want something I haven't got.
So is that a significant other? Is that someone to share your life with?
Just don't know, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I think for me, the bank is really good because it gives me the opportunity to achieve something.
I can't believe a dream is the bank.
It's not a dream.
So
no,
what is your dream?
It's not a dream.
That's the whole thing. You asked us a question. So
yeah.
Go, wait, no, right, no. Literally smash the bank out of the way. What's the dream?
Yeah.
No,
there
no,
has
no,
to be a dream.
My dream is just to succeed in whatever I do. To
no,
be
it isn't.
It is, though.
It is.
It isn't, though, is it?
No, but we don't live in a perfect world, do we?
Well, it's a dream isn't yours.
That's the whole point of a dream. A dream is a perfect world. But it's not like I'm going to have a dream, but my dream is substandard because I know there's restrictions upon it. The dream is a freaking dream.
Okay, this is what I want, and I'm going to have it.
Come on,
but
come
darling, then it's just only a dream with
it's fantasy. Dream is a fantasy.
There's no need for that.
Dream is a fantasy.
Well, that went well.
That didn't happen. That didn't happen. Am I in a dream? These all fictional. Please tell me these people are fictional.
The conversation took a bit of a turn, a bit of a dark turn.
Yes, because of you!
I'll clear the plates.
The duck was nice.
We'll talk about something else.
No, it was. That's the question, he kept buying it off. I just wanted the answer.
No, he didn't. You asked impossible questions. You were horrible.
Mark just flew out of nowhere into this raging ball. I don't like people like that in my house. It's not my kind of person, and that's disgusting.
So a thoroughly disgusted Lachlan takes a stab at soothing the raging bull through the medium of song.
There, out in the darkness, a fugitive running.
Lachlan, voice amazing. Literally, why are you in a bank? You are a great singer.
So it is written.
Just for once was lost for words.
This three of us watching, like, it's a bit weird. And like, if you're not into it, I'm not a big fan of Les Mis.
I think Joy might be.
I was in awe.
Anything else?
In awe.
Thanks for your comments.
Oh,
well, Lachlan's dulcet tones seem to have lifted the mood, but will dessert have them singing his praises?
If this doesn't pull them back from the brink, nothing will.
Good on you! White and dark chocolate torte with some of the trimmings.
Wow! Do I use fork or spoon?
Use whatever you like, love. Use your hand. I don't mind. Go for it.
Thank you.
The top layer had a layer of white chocolate on. That had some flavour, the white chocolate. Everything below it, what was it even there for? I didn't even taste it.
It was just a pudding. Easy, but really nice.
The first minute I met you, I thought you were all quite normal. And then now, last day, you're all nutters.
No, I thought I was normal, and I thought you particularly weren't, actually.
I thought you were nuts.
But actually, I think you're probably the most normal now.
I felt as the week's gone on, I've really, really liked you, and I feel like today I've annoyed you a little bit.
That's an understatement.
And Joy.
She's nice.
She isn't nice all the time, is she? Got two sides.
I don't know where this thunderbolt came from, but it arrived, and there was definitely an elephant in the room, and it's so sad.
Well done, Mark. And on that cheery note, it's time to find out who's won £1,000.
It's been a really eventful night. A lot's happened. I feel like I've run the gamut of emotions this evening.
Me and all.
But it's been an experience. I'll host another dinner party and none of them will be invited, that's for sure.
The food was quite good. The atmosphere was whack. And the entertainment made me feel a little bit awkward. That's why I'm giving him a 6.
To be honest, the entertainment was amazing, but the vibe around the table wasn't as it has been the last couple of nights. So I'm going to have to give Lachlan a 6.
So Lachlan needs a 7 from Joy to win.
I'm going to score you.
Hold it, Joy! Let's hear it from the man himself.
OK. Ooh. In joint third place, it's Koya and Lachlan.
Joy gave Lachlan a 5, giving him 17, equal with Koya.
Your food was better than mine.
In joint first, it's Joy and Mark.
I would have thought there'd be a moment me and you were together.
That shows me why I have my close circle of friends and I don't allow riffraff like that into my house.
Koya, Lachlan, I love them to pieces. We'll be partying. We're going to have a massive... We're going to do loads of things together. The other one.
I feel almost robbed that I drew, but I'm going to take it and the banner is meant, I'm still a winner.
They're all Fruit Loops. I'm not being funny, I'm not seeing any of them again. Ta-ra. Well done.
For more on Come Dine With Me, head to the Channel 4 website.
Well, tackling a huge contributor to global health problems, Jamie's Sugar Rush, next Thursday night at 9. On the way next, this evening, well, Marge agrees to a little marital subterfuge in The Simpsons.